Hello everyone, welcome to MATLAB tutorial brought to you by MATLAB helper. In this video tutorial, we will see how to design a Butterworth IIR low pass filter using impulse invariance method. So to write the code, we consider a problem. Design a Butterworth IIR filter using impulse invariance transformation by taking t is equals to 1 second and this is the given equation. From this equation, we can find out attenuation in passband, AP, attenuation in stopband, AS, passband edge frequency, omega P, and stopband edge frequency, omega S. Now let us write solution code for this example. Starting with clear all and CLC, we define the given terms AP, AS, omega P, omega S and T equal to 1, which is given in the question. Next, we convert the attenuation in passband AP and attenuation in stopband AS into decibels. In impulse invariance method, we use the formula capital omega, that is the horseshoe omega, equals the corner frequency upon sampling time T, which is 1 in our case. So we implement this formula and calculate the new corner and edge frequencies for both passband and stop bands. Now this function n, wn, which is equal to butord into the bracket calculate passband frequency, comma calculate stop band frequency, comma passband attenuation in decibels and comma stopband attenuation in decibels finds the minimum order n and cutoff frequency wn for an analog Butterworth filter. The last term in the bracket, which is s, denotes that we are working in analog domain. And if it is absent or we forget to write it, the code will show an error or give wrong answers. Next command is butter n, wn, which returns the transfer function coefficients of an nth order low pass digital Butterworth filter with normalized cutoff frequency wn. Next command is tf, which creates a transfer function model. We again apply the butter command and find the unnormalized function. As we are using the impulse invariance method, we use the command impinvar, impinvar, which creates a digital filter with numerator and denominator coefficients num and den respectively, whose impulse response is equal to impulse response of the analog filter with coefficients b and a scaled by 1 by t. Again, we create a transfer function model, which is our required transfer function of IIR filter. We define W from 0 to pi with an interval of pi by 16. Now we find the frequency response and then we find the absolute value of obtained frequency response, which is our magnitude response, and plot it against W by pi with the title magnitude response of a Butterworth IIR filter. Let us now run the code. So this is the output magnitude response of the given Butterworth IIR filter using impulse invariance method. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Don't forget to hit the like button. Also subscribe to our channel for updates on more such videos. For any queries, write us through the comment section down below. Thank you. Bye-bye.